everyone, welcome back again to Mommy T and V YouTube channel. If today is your first time of coming across my YouTube channel, please do subscribe and join the family. For my old subscribers, God bless you. In this video, we are going to be talking about know the reason you volunteer to serve your maker. Part two of the video. Know the reason you volunteer to serve your maker. In that part one, I've seen so many comments on that video. Some people said the pastor have to be receiving money. The workers also have to be receiving money. What I said is that when you volunteer to work for God, you don't have to receive any money from it. When you volunteer and it's from your heart, you said, before you volunteer to work for God, you have to have something doing. Because you can't say you volunteer to work for God and you want to be receiving money from it. That means you did not volunteer to work for God. If you volunteer to be a preacher, you volunteer to do it. Just like there are some people who volunteer to be giving the orphanage, to be giving them food. They just volunteer to be helping the orphanage. They are not receiving a dime for it. They volunteer to do it with all their hearts. Just as the same thing, when you volunteer to serve God, you volunteer to be an evangelist, to preach the gospel. When you volunteer, it's different way. When you volunteer to work for God, you don't have to be receiving money. You don't have to expect anybody to pay you. That is what I said. I don't know if people are not getting it. Hallelujah. When you volunteer to work for God, you don't have to be receiving anything. I said the people that volunteer, it's just like when you volunteer and said, I want to be paying the church rents. I want to be paying the church rents, and nobody should join me to pay the church rents. You volunteer to pay the church rents. You don't want the pastor to come and pay you back. No, because you volunteer to do it. Just like also with pastors and other people who volunteer within their hearts to spread the gospel, they don't have to be receiving money. Except the pastor is not working. Except the pastor is not working, and the member can also decide to be paying the pastor. But when you are working, you have other business you are doing. You are working and you have other business you are doing. And everybody know that, yes, you are okay. And you still want to be, you still want people to be paying you salary. That means you did not volunteer to work for God. That means you want to help people. That is why you want to preach the gospel to save life. Stand on it. Except you are a pastor and you are not working, you don't have any business you are doing. Sometimes the truth is bitter. I know some people, they are working for God and they have something that is giving them money at the end of the month, and they are still collecting from people. Those are the people I am talking about. Those are the people I am talking to. I am telling them to have conscience and they should know the reason why they are working for Christ. When you are a preacher, you are a pastor, and you don't have any other means of any money at the end of the month, the church can do something about it. Doubt is quite different. But when you are a preacher, you are a pastor, you have many things that is giving you money, you have school, you have filling station, and you have many other business you are doing, and you still want to be receiving salary when people are hungry in your church, that means you didn't volunteer to work for God. You volunteer to work for God, you don't need to expect any salary from it, especially when you are working. Especially when you have something that is giving you money at the end of the month and you decide to work for God, you don't need to be paid, because it's from your heart. You want to spread the gospel. You want people to know Christ. Except as a pastor, you are not working. You are not receiving anything at the end of the month. That is where you can, the church can consider to be giving you salary at the end of the month. But for those that volunteer to work for God and you are working, those are the people I am talking about. You are working, you are a pastor, and you have filling station, you have businesses that is giving you money, and you still want the church to be paying you at the end of the month. That means you did not volunteer to work for God. Hallelujah. When you volunteer to work for God, you need to be concerned about others. That is why you are a worker of God. That is why you volunteer to work for God. You volunteer to work for God so that you can be able to save life. How can you save the life? Through the word of God. When you look at the book of Philippians 2 verse 4, it says, don't be concerned only about your interest, but also be concerned about the interest of others. He said, don't be concerned about your own interest. Hallelujah. Let us just quickly look at the book of 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians 9 verse 6. Then we'll take it to verse 8. I don't want this video to be too long. Let's just take it to verse 8. He said, and are Barnabas and the only ones who must work to earn our living. No soldier ever serves in the army and pays his own salary. No one ever plants a vineyard without eating. No one takes care of the flock and sheep without drinking some of the milk himself. Said, those are my old thoughts. Say, God's law says the same thing. Yes, it is written in the law of Moses. When a work animal is being used to separate grain, does not keep it from eating the grain. When God said this, was he talking about holy animal? No, he was talking about us. Hallelujah. God was not talking to animal, he was talking to us. Wherever you are walking, you need to eat from it. But you need to do it with respect. Those Barnabas, they were not earning anything. They were not working. So they have to look into it and they have to look into it so that they can be earn any salary at the end of the month. That is the same thing I'm talking about. I said when you are not walking, when you go through that verse, we can't go through it. Just read it to 14. You will understand it. Barnabas and the 12 disciples, they were not earning anything. They were not working. But they were working for Christ. As they were not working, they now decided to say, we are not working. We need something. That one is quite different. They are not working. They are working for Christ. They are not earning any salary. Just like some pastor, when they post them to some villages to go and pastor there, the churches have to take their responsibility. That is what this verse is also telling us. But if you are working and you volunteer to work for God, you are working and you also volunteer to work for God. You are receiving salary. You have your own business you are doing. And you volunteer to work for God, you don't have to be any salary. You don't have to be receiving anything from it. God bless you for your understanding. Thank you for watching. Thank you for stopping by. If today is your first time of coming across my video, please do subscribe. God bless you. See you on my next video. Bye.